Hello, people. My name is Shams.
My name is Emma.
Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Eric.
Hi, guys. I'm Diana, and today we're going to teach you guys about the Kelly v. Board of Trustees case, case number 35FD265 at the Seventh Circuit Court in 1994.
Man, get out of here, man! Get out of here, man!
Boys, your swimming team just got caught!
What?
I'm gonna get this, man.
Let's get her.
Did you cut us?
Yes, guys. Well, let's have a seat. Let's calm down here.
You telling me to calm down? You're not.
I'm gonna calm down.
He gets the lawyers on you. And he gets the lawyers.
We're gonna sue you. I'll see you in court.
I'll see you in court. Guys, we're gonna be back.
I'll be back.
I don't even care.
All right. Sorry I'm late. We got business to attend to. Very serious matter. We know what it is. It's all about the budget. Right? Okay.
I think we really have to consider to cut some teams.
I think we have to too. We just can't afford anything.
Yeah, we'd like to consider and cut some teams. We really have to keep in mind the Title IX rules, that we can't just cut some teams like that. And obviously also we have to consider the rules about it.
At the end of the day, what are we here for? To make money. So we gotta make money. We gotta do.
That's the goal.
All right, so we got 19 teams on campus. We got to cut some of them. We got to get back. We got to cut the budget deficit. With this.
How are you going to decide who to cut?
Honestly,
I mean, obviously we have to look at the cost. We got to find the teams that cost the most, and also we have to consider some gender and ethnic issues.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Also, we should think about, do we have interest in the high school level and also our facilities.
Yeah, we've got some places that need to be fixed up.
Yeah.
Like that pool.
I definitely agree with that.
And then also we want to look if the sports in one of the major conferences. If not, they're not making money, and if they're eligible to even compete for an NCAA championship. If they're not eligible, what's the point? You know? Then also we gotta look at the tradition of success. Do they win? If they don't win, they're not generating any money.
Right.
So
we also have to look at those spectator interests. When people buy tickets, we make money. No matter how bad a place is. Buy tickets, we make money, that's good for us. But if we don't have people showing up, what are we gonna do?
I think I know some teams. 3 hours
later. Alright, so we made a decision. We're cutting 4 teams. And the decision took a lot of time, took about 3 hours, but we made it. And I think it's a pretty good decision.
All right, so one of them is the men's fencing. For the people who don't know what fencing is that with a little sword. So why are we going to cut the men's fencing? We're going to cut the men's fencing because they don't sell any tickets. They're not even in the NCAA, and they lose a lot of matches during the season.
Okay. Also, we will cut men's diving because there is no any fans. We don't have good facilities, and there is also no interest in the high school level.
And along with that, we're also going to cut women's diving, mostly for the same reasons. The facilities, they're not good. Nobody in high school really does. Nobody does diving at all, really. It's not common.
Yeah, the diving's expensive. We're also going to have to cut the men's swimming team because, listen, our pool has to get redone if we're going to host any meets, and we just can't afford that right now. And they haven't been winning much, and we really can't afford to hold on to them any longer. They're not going to.
Yeah. Title IX is basically what it means is that no persons in the United States shall, on the basis of sex, be excluded from participation in, be denied the benefits of, or be subjected to discrimination under any educational program or activity receiving federal financial assistance. Simply, it just means that it prohibits programs that receive federal funding from excluding people participating in programs, and it prohibits discrimination against unrepresented sex, which historically has been women.
Okay, guys, open your eyes. So what did we learn from the video?
Who is the plaintiff and who is the defendant here?
Okay. Eric, who is the plaintiff?
The plaintiff is Kelly.
Good. And the defendant is?
The defendant is the Board of Trustees.
Good. Does anyone else have any questions?
So, like, they also mentioned the fact about statistical balancing. But what is statistical balancing exactly?
So, the statistical balancing, the plaintiff brought up as they wanted it to be used in evaluating how the numbers were looked at regarding the proportionality of athletes to student athletes, male to female, but it's really not a part of Title IX. Eric.
All right, I got a question about parallel teams.
Okay.
And so why do they or do they not need to exist? Like, what's the big deal about it?
Okay, so you play football, right?
Yeah.
Is there a women's football team?
Nope.
Right. But we have men's and women's hockey, correct? Or soccer, right? So you don't have to have parallel teams. If you do, great, but they have to focus on the student body and student athletes' interests of what they want to be in. So if we say had a team of men swimming, but we didn't have a women's swimming team and we wanted a women's swimming team, that would be a problem. Okay, so are there any more questions?
I have one more question. So what would exactly happen if they also would cut the women's swimming team?
Okay, so as we saw, what women's team got cut?
The diving?
Right. So women are protected, are a protected class under Title IX, which could become a potential problem if they were to cut the team and they didn't show parts of the three-prong test occurring at the school. Any other questions? Yes, Emma?
Who won this case?
Okay, so the Board of Trustees won the case, but there has never been a group of men or a single man that have won a Title IX case in court. Okay. That could be a bonus on the test.
Mm-hmm. And I got a question. So what exactly does the 14th Amendment go into with this case?
Okay, so it was a last-ditch effort by Kelly for the men's swim team that was suing, because they were losing the case. But they were arguing for equal protection, and that's why it was their last-ditch effort. And the court said, no, we don't agree, and shut it down. So who can tell me the first prong from the three-prong test under Title IX that the court had to look at in order to figure out the determination of this case? Emma?
The first prong had something to do with proportionation, right?
Right. So when we look at a school, a university like ours, we have to look to see the female to male student ratio and then see if that is equivalent or close to equivalent within range of our student athletes as well. So if we have 60% male and 40% female, our student athletic body should also represent a percentage similar to that. So who can tell me the second prong?
I think it has to do with the history, where the second test focuses on whether the institution can show history and continue practicing of the program. Also, if they are responsive to the developing interests and abilities of the members of the underrepresented sex.
Right. Very good. So, Eric, do you know the third?
Absolutely. It's all about accommodating interests. So basically, you want to make sure that the interests and abilities of both sexes of students are both accommodated. And to determine whether or not those interests are being met, you have to, basically the schools have to survey their student bodies and make sure, you know, they know what's going on, know what their students are in the population that exists
right
there.
So something as simple as a survey could be sent out to the athletes or to the whole student body. And that can show whether they have been working on accommodating the interest, but it can also give information for the athletic department to know what they should do next.
Okay, so after reviewing the case, what are your guys' thoughts? Like, how did you feel about it? Because I know I felt bad for the team and that they lost in the case, but I also felt bad for the university that they had to go through it because they're already having the money problems.
And I mean, I know our budgets get a little tight around here, and we have a hard time making ends meet. So, what do you guys think?
I know. No one ever won a Title IX case, but I kind of disagree because last year at my university back home in Atlanta, they cut the women's tennis team, and a lot of them were in the last year in their junior year, and they just had one more year, and they couldn't find another school, so they were like kind of in trouble, and they had a tough time. A lot of them were desperate, and they didn't know what to do. So,
I don't agree with the decision because my hockey team last year in North Dakota got caught, and we had to find a new school where to go, and it was just a hard time for everyone. And I totally understand those women boys, so I understand why they make the lawsuit, and I'm not happy that they lost the case.
Even though they were the guys?
Still, it's not right for anyone.
Yeah. Basically, I agree, just for the simple fact that if you're losing money someplace, that's not necessary. Where you need, like, you don't need to be losing money there. Just get rid of it, because at the end of the day, school's a business, and they still got to make money, and they just can't lose money over sports that no one goes to, no one's interested in. The facilities are garbage, so that's just my opinion.
I mean, I think that's where the problem is. If schools, like, this is maybe one of them, but like if it happens more often, that school's really gonna be a business instead of taking care of their students and of the future of their students. You know, some students can take care of some responsibilities and even find another school, but a lot of them, they can't. So that's also a bad thing. If university is just going to think about money, and business, it's going to be bad for the students.
Do you guys think that a men's group or a group of men or a single man is ever going to win a Title IX case?
Hopefully one day. Hopefully.
They can probably not.
Probably not. We'll see.
Okay. Thanks for watching. We're the A-Team, and we hope you learned something today about Kelly V. Board of Trustees.